Welcome to Science Tour online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Welcome to all my dear students. Today I'm taking biology class. Under that we are studying the plant kingdom. Okay, here last class we studied about the bryophytes, remaining part of the bryophytes, as well as we started with the pteridophytes. In bryophytes we studied about the mosses. The good example for moss is Phenaria and Polytrichum, and one more good example is Sphagnum. These are the different example for mosses, and we have studied the two different phases of mosses, that is Protonema phase and Leafy phase. Okay, and we studied the reproduction system, and we started with the pteridophytes. Here in pteridophytes it is nothing but the sporophyte. The dominant phase of the plant body is sporophytic, and that gave rise to the leaf of the leaf like structure, or the leaf we'll call it as there are two types of leaf present based on their size, that is microphylls and macrophylls. A smaller leaf we'll call it as microphylls, and larger leaf we'll call it as macrophylls. You can see in this. Okay, here in this plant you can see very small leaf. Okay, these are nothing but microphylls. In some of them you can see the larger leaf. You can see a larger leaf. This is macrophylls. Okay, here they contain in the on the ventral surface of the leaf, they may contain spores, spore bearing structure, that is sporophylls. Okay, that spore bearing leaf structure we'll call it as sporophylls. Okay, spore bearing leaf like structure we'll call it as sporophylls. Usually the sporangia is subtended appendages like structure which bears the sporangium. Okay, subtended appendage like structure, leaf like structure with the sporangium, that leaf will call it as sporophyll, spore bearing structure. And we study the dominant phase of the plant body is sporophyte. Here the sporophyte will give rise to the undergo meiotic division and produces the spores, which are haploid in nature, and these haploid spores will germinate and produces a gametophytic phase. It produces a independent gametophyte here. Here it produces a dominant sporophytic phase. We can see dominant sporophytic phase, and they have independent, they also show independent gametophytic phase. Here usually these gametophyte are diploid in condition, sporophyte is diploid in condition, gametophytic phase is haploid in condition. That gametophyte will give rise to, remember very easy, gametophyte means gamete producing plant body. Okay, gamete producing plant body is called as phyta, means plant. Gamete producing plant body will call it as gametophyte, spore producing plant body will call it as sporophyte. Okay, don't make confusion between these two. Okay, here they produce independent gametophyte from the spores produced by sporophyte. Sporophyte in the producer are the spores, gametophyte develop aagtade, and this independent green multicellular structure will call it as prothallus. Okay, this green independent multicellular structure produced from the germination of the spores is called as prothallus. These are prothallus is nothing but the gametophytic phase of pteridophytes. It is nothing but the gametophytic phase of pteridophytes, and this prothallus may produce two different gametes, that is male and female gamete, in two different structure, that is antheridia and archegonia. In this you can see the development of male and female gametes. They fuse and form a zygote, and the zygote later gave rise to the sporophytic structure. Here idu haploid haploid irthade, male and female gamete, they fuse form a diploid zygote, andre two set of chromosome hondiruvanta cell anna produce martade, adanna zygote heltave. That zygote further divide and form a sporophytic structure, and this prothallus structure or the gametophytic phase of pteridophytes require cool, humid, moist and shady regions. Okay, they require cool, humid, moist and shady region to the growth of to the germination of the spore. So because of this particular availability for a particular the environmental condition to these prothallus, for the production of prothallus they require particular type of environmental condition, so they are only confined to the particular geographical area. So we cannot see these pteridophytes in all the places because of the this prothallus development, which is confined to the particular environmental condition. Slight variation will not result in the formation of gametophytic phase. Yavde variation solpa variation idru gametophytic stage develop agudilla. So this is about the development, how the gametophytic phase and sporophytic phase develop. Just I'll draw the cycle. Sporophytic is dominant, that is 2N. This produces meiosis, this undergo meiosis and produces sporangium. Inside sporangium few cells undergo spore mother cell. Inside the sporangium it contains a spore mother cell that gave rise to spores by meiotic division, and these spores will give rise to gametophyte, that is prothallus. This is haploid in condition. This is haploid in condition. This will give rise to male and female gametes. Okay, this fuse and produce zygote. Okay, zygote later develop into embryo. Multicellular structure we'll call it as embryo, developed from the zygote. Zygote first ki unicellular agirthade, so it is diploid in condition. This is haploid and this is haploid. Single set of chromosome irthade idralli female matte male gamete alli. They fuse and form a diploid zygote. Okay, and they produce diploid embryo. Okay, multicellular structure of the zygote. After zygote formation they undergo division and form a multicellular mass like structure. Ondu mass ondu mudde tara ondu structure aagutade adanna embryo antu helteve. From embryo there is a further development of the sporophyte. This cycle continues. Okay, ee cycle continue aagta hogtade. Okay, next that later gave this type of life cycle will call my name. Okay, that you are going to study in next class. Okay, in last class you are going to study. Just you should know the generation. Okay, here usually these pteridophytes contain, few of the pteridophytes contain a single type of spores. Here, most of the pteridophytes contain single type of spores. So, that type of spores we'll call it as homospores. That type of organism we'll call it as homosporous. Okay, homosporous, and where similar, where it contains similar sized or type of spores. Here it contains similar types of spore or it contains a similar size or similar type of spores. That type of organism will call it as homosporous or homospore. Okay, that condition will call it as homosporous. Some of the for example, you can see in ferns, almost all the ferns will produce similar kind of spores. Okay, next, some of the organisms, some of the pteridophytes contain two types of spores, that is micro and macrospores. This type of this condition we'll call it as heterosporous. Heterosporous, this contain micro and macrosporous, that condition we'll call it as heterosporous. Hetero on the different, homo on the similar. Okay, you should know the this technical term, the meaning of the technical term. Homo means similar, hetero means different. Okay, homo heterosporous condition, this seen in Selaginella and Salvinia. Salvinia is it is a type of pteridophytes which grow in aquatic condition. Aquatic conditionally grow up to there. Somewhat leaf will like this. You can see the leaf structure. Okay, it is commonly grow as a weed. Water weed agi grow up to the tara. Okay, and it contains small hair like structure, so that it will, the water droplet will not settle. Okay, there you can clearly see the water droplets on the surface. Okay, adu enagutte water absorb madudilla, enagutte water absorb madidre it will start to decay. So in order to prevent that, they have a small hair like structure that will prevent the flow of water. Okay, so this is a structure of Salvinia. Itara structure irutade, you can see like this structure commonly seen. Salvinia commonly available weed plant in aquatic region. Aquatic in iga pond athava lake alli neevu nodidre ee Salvinia weed agi beldirutade. Okay, so next, these are heterosporous. Here microspore will give rise to the male gametes. Male gametophyte. Here the microspore will give rise to the male gametophyte. This microspore will germinate and form a male gametophyte, and macrospores will germinate and produce as a female gametophyte. Female gametophyte. Okay, here the macrospores will germinate and produce as a female gametophyte, and microspore will develop into a male gametophyte. Okay, these are the two different conditions we can see based on the size of the spores. And we have studied example ferns alli homosporous condition irutade, Selaginella and Salvinia we can see the heterosporous condition where it produces micro and macrospores. And here these microspores will give rise to the male gametophyte, and macrospore will give rise to the female gametophyte. Here the female gametophyte produces archegonium. Male gametophyte will give rise to the antheridium. Okay, here antheridium will give rise to the male spores, that is anthrozoids, and female archegonia will give rise to the single egg at the base of the flask shaped structure. These anthrozoids are motile in nature. When there is a adequate water supply, these anthrozoids will flow into the female gametophyte, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಥ್ರೋಜಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದು ವಾಟರ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸಿಂದ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೀಳ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಎಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್, ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ ಆಗಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೇಸಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಮೇನ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೋನ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೊಬೈಲಸ್. ಈ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಒಳಗೇನೆ ಈ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಉಳಿತದೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಆಂಥ್ರೋಜಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಗೀವ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜನ್ರೇಷನಿಗೆ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟನ್ನು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಸ್ಪೋರನ್ನು ಅದೇ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಹೊಂದಿರ್ತದೆ. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮೇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್. ಸೀಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೀಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೀಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೆಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಈ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಇವನ್ ದೋ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಗೋನಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್, ಎಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಉಳಿತದೆ. ಆ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಉಳಿದಂತಹ ಈ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಆಂಥ್ರೋಜಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬಂದು ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದೇ ದ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್. ಮೇಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುವಂತಹ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಆಂಥ್ರೋಜಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಗಿವ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇವಾಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅವ್ರ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಶೋ ಬೋತ್ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ಸ್. ಎರಡು ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಅಂತಹ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ಗಳು ಲಿಂಕನ್ನು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫ್ಯೂ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫೈವ್ ಮೈನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೈಲೋಪ್ಸಿಡಾ. Lycopsida, Sphenopsida and Pteropsida. Four main classes, that is Xylopsida, Pteropsida, Xylopsida, Lycopsida, Sphenopsida and Pteropsida. Okay, Sphenopsida, here Sphenopsida. Example, these are the different classes of pteridophytes. Okay, these are the different classes of pteridophytes. Example for Xylopsida, Xylotum. Usually the xylotum structure, a small plant, the highly branched plant branching we can see like this. There are branching irtade, profusely branched, it is highly branched structure. Okay, and this branch contain spore bearing structure. These are spore bearing structure, that is sporangium. Okay, allalli spore orange to red colored spore bearing structure hondirtade. This is the structure of xylotome. Okay, next example is Lycopsida. So for this, it's a Lagenella and Lycopodium. Okay, one more example, that is Lycopodium. Usually the Selaginella looks like this. You can see the live plant example for Selaginella. Usually you can see the very clear picture of Selaginella. Okay, you can also see the strobilus in this. Okay, strobilus or cones at the tip, you can see, you can observe the cones in the plant. Tippalli somewhat light green color irthadalla, that is nothing but the cone like cone structure of the this Selaginella. Selaginella dalli microspores and megaspores will develop in a specialized cone like structure. Ithara cone like structure irthade. This will call it as strobilus or cone. In this you can see the development of these spores, different kinds of spores. Okay, Lycopsida usually same as this. This is the structure of Lycopodium. The leaf, all the entire axis, all the axis is covered with the leaf structure, leafy structure in the cover agirthade, and at the tip you can see the cone. This is a structure of Lycopodium. Next, for Sphenopsida can give example. For Sphenopsida can give example Equisetum. Okay, Equisetum. Equisetum is an example for Sphenopsida class. Okay, here usually this we have studied in a while studying the strobilus. Okay, strobilus study madvaga Equisetum example and atakondideve. Usually it having a stem. Okay. It have nodes and internodal structure. In internodal structure you can see the leaf like structure, and at the tip you can see the strobilus with the spores. This is leaf, this is stem, strobilus, and here at the base you can see the roots. You can see the roots. This is a structure of Equisetum. And next Pteropsida, you can give Dryopteris. Teres. Yes, commonly the group of this Pteropsida plants will call it as ferns. Okay, usually the plant which comes under the class Pteropsida will call it as ferns. Okay, and Teres, Adiantum. Okay, usually this Dryopteris, which looks like this. This is nothing but the Dryopteris structure. Okay, this is clear. Observe the plant clearly. You can see in your area, in your gardens or near your forest areas or on the walls. You can see like this plant grow. This is nothing but Dryopteris. Okay, this is Dryopteris, and the Teres usually looks like this. This is also similar to the Dryopteris. Okay, hegirthadandre can see the branching like this. There are branching irthade. ತರ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಇನ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಓಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರಯೋಪ್ಟೆರೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾರಿ ಟೀರೀಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀರೀಸ್. Okay, next one more example commonly seen in your places on the wall, mud compounds you can see, where you can see the presence of these terrace structures, and also at the base of the your arachnid farm, arachnid plantation will be there, no? At the base, these type of terrace you can see, and also in a forest area you can see the development of or the growth of this terrace. And next one is Adiantum. This Adiantum is also called as walking ferns. Okay, it is also called as walking ferns because when the stem touches the axis or the stem like structure touches the ground, it produces a new bud. Okay, new bud, again it grow and it touches the ground, it produces new bud. Okay, that's why they shows like a walking like features, walking like patterns. That's why this Adiantum usually called as walking ferns. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟಮ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸಾಯ್ಲನ್ನು ರೀಚ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಟಚ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಆಗ ಅದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ರೈಸಾಯ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಬರ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಗ್ರೋ ವೆನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ಬರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದ ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಅಡಿಯಾಂಟಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಫರ್ನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್. Okay, one more important division. Should remember this gametophytic and the sporophytic phase. Remember maadkolbeku. Don't get confused in between that. I have clearly explained. Okay, next we'll study about the one more important division, that is gymnosperms. Gymnosperms, where gymnosperms are also called as naked seed containing plant, where gymno means naked. Gymno means naked. Sperma means seeds. Okay, naked seed containing plant we'll call it as gymnosperms. Here they undergo fertilization and produce a zygote, and this egg from the ovule, the fertilization produces a seed, and that seed is not covered with fruit walls. Usually in higher angiospermic plant we are eating the fruits, apple, mango and orange we eat, that the fleshy part is called as fruity layer. Fleshy part irthadalla, what we consume, that is a fruit part. Okay, in gymnosperms that fruit part or ovary part is absent, so only seed will be developed. Only seed developed in the plants, so that type of seed containing plant usually called as gymnosperms, where it contains naked seeds. Usually they are small trees. They reach up to small trees and tall trees. They include small trees, tall trees. You can see different variation in the size of the plant, and also some of them are shrubs, some of them grow as a shrub, some of them grow as a small tree, and some of them will grow as a very tall trees, and few also grow as a climber. Okay, for example, it is not given, some of the gymnosperms also climber. We can see the habitat, climber habit. Okay, climber, for example, neetam anta ondu gymnosperm ide. This, their habitat is climber, which climb, which get a support, which require support of other plant to grow. Okay, usually they are tall trees and shrubs also. Some of them are climbers. And one more example is sequoia. Sequoia is a very tallest tree, redwood. It is also called as redwood tree, which measures up to 900 to 2600 meters. Very tall tree. We can if we stand on front of the tree, will looks like this much small. Okay, that tree is so big, measures up to 900 to 2600 meters. That sequoia. Okay, sequoia is a type of gymnosperm conifer. Santhaltare, it is a type of conifer which is a tallest tree, measures up to 900 to 2600 meters. Okay, some of them are branched, some of them are unbranched, means the aerial part, the shoot part is unbranched. For example, cycas is a common type of gymnosperm. You have seen in your gardens or any garden alli some coconut tree like smaller plants, you can see coconut tree like. Okay, hegirtadandre this is a thick stem. Okay, you can see like this stem, and on the top you can see the presence of coconut tree like leaf. Have observed in commonly seen in any of the gardens. This is nothing but cycas, and here the aerial part or the shoot part is unbranched. Here shoot part is unbranched. Example, cycas, and few of them are branched. Can see highly branched shoot system also present. For example, pinus, it is a type of conifer, and cedrus, it is also a type of conifer. Okay, usually gymnosperm plant, tree plants irthadala adana conifers anta karitare. For example, pinus and cedrus, which is a highly branched, highly branched shoot system. Okay, here it contain taproot system. Mainly the plant contain taproot system. In these, a few of them have a fungal association. Few of the cycas members, or sorry, gymnosperm members, this taproot system is associated with fungal association. Having fungal association, some of the taproot system have fungal association called mycorrhiza. Mycorrhizae. This fungal association of this higher taproot system is called as that association of fungus and the root system is called as mycorrhizae. Okay, and few of them, for example, the cycas will produce us this is a taproot system of the cycas. Consider this is a taproot system of the cycas. This is a lateral root system. Okay, this lateral, some of the lateral roots grow on lateral side, and they grow, some of the roots will grow upwards. Okay, they grow upwards and form a coral like structure. Okay, they grow upwards, some of the roots, lateral roots grow upward, form a coral like structure. This will call it as coralloid root. These roots are called as coralloid roots. This type of roots we'll call it as coralloid roots. This type of roots, which is developed from the lateral roots of the main tap root system. Main tap root system alli lateral root system develop aagtadala, adu coral type idu roots anna develop maartade. That we'll call it as coralloid root. And this coralloid root having a nitrogen fixing algae, N2 fixing algae, that is nostoc. Nostoc anna coralloid roots, if you take a section adana chanda section tegdu observe madidaga, you can find the nostoc colonies inside this coralloid roots that help to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. N2 fixing algae anna hondirtade, nitrogen fixing algae anna hondirtade. Usually nostoc and anabina will fix the atmospheric nitrogen, but in case of coralloid root you can see the presence of nostoc colonies, and this specialized structure we'll call it as coralloid root. May be asked for 1 mark. Ellirtade yava plant alli nodabodu N2 fixing algae or coralloid root system, that is in cycas. In cycas plant we can see the development of coralloid roots that contain a N2 fixing algae. They contain N2 fixing algae, and some of them have a mycorrhizal association, fungal association, we will call it as mycorrhiza, that help to, that give extra nutrition to the plant. Okay, next we will move to the next. Okay, they are well adapted to extreme condition. They may be well adapted to extreme environmental condition, that is high temperature. They may adapted to high temperature. They can withstand high temperature, humidity and wind. They can withstand the variation in the temperature, humidity and winds. Usually most of the gymnosperms grow in a cold region where there is a less humidity and less temperature, and most of them will grow in an extreme condition where there is a high temperature and humidity, less humidity, high wind condition. Our regional is a grow aagtade. They can withstand any of the environmental condition compared to pteridophytes and bryophytes. These are most evolved in the ecological habitat for the adaptation to the different ecological habitat. These organisms are more adapted. Andre adakke bega adjust aagtade. Pteridophytes matte bryophytes leno, they require moist condition, high water concentration for the fertilization. But here then no need of that water, shady region, adradella availability beda irtade. So here the leaf may be pinnate. The leaf usually pinnate in case of cycas. Okay, maybe simple or compound. You can see simple or compound type of leaf. Simple means a single leaf. Single leaf structure we'll call it as single ithara leaf irtadalla, idanna simple leaf ant heldire. Sometimes what happens, this leaf will leaf a lamina like structure irtadalla, green surface area untala, that form a, that is divided. Okay, that is divided form a small leaflet like structure. It is not a true, the single section will not, we won't call it as a leaf. Instead we'll call it as a leaflet. So idana leaflets anta helteve. The divide, this main lamina will divide and form a smaller leaf like structure, that we'll call it as leaflets. And this type of leaflet, this type of the leaf we'll call it as compound leaf. Okay, yavaga ee lamina portion divide aagi chikka chikka leaf aagi develop aagtada, each leaf anna leaflets anta helteve. And that type of entire leaf we'll call it as, that modification of the leaf, or we'll call it as compound leaf. Here it contains simple and compound type of leaf. Compound in case of cycas, pinnately compound irutade, that you are going to study in detail. Morphologically ivaga pinnate matte simple leaf bagge we are studying in detail. In cycas which the leaf assumes like a coconut tree leaf you have observed alva, gari tengina gari neevu nodirtire elladralli ellaru sa hege irutade, a large central axis, okay. A large central axis, okay, and you can see the leaf lets on the lateral surface, okay. Hege develop agirtadalla, this is nothing but the leaflet, and this type of leaf we'll call it as compound leaf. This type of leaf we'll call it as compound leaf. Like this leaf structure you can see in cycas. Cycas alli ide reetiya leaf structure irutade. So this is compound leaf. This is an example for compound type of leaf, okay, where you can see many leaflets. Itara leaflets irutade. In some cases the leaf is modified into a needle like structure. In some cases the leaf is modified into needle like structure. For example, in pinus you can see this leaf is modified into a needle like structure. Here you can see this is smaller dwarf branch, it contains leaf like this needle like structure. The needle like structure develop aagtade, so that decreases the surface area of the leaf. Ee tara idenagutte surface area jaasti aagutte. Surface area jaasti aadage enagtade, transpiration jaasti aagtade. So in order to decrease the transpiration, andre transpiration andre enta, loss of water through stomata. Stomata yake beku, for the gaseous exchange. Gaseous exchange ge stomata beku, along with this gaseous exchange this stomata will perform a one more important process, that is transpiration, that is loss of water through stomata. That process we'll call it as transpiration. Aa transpiration enagtade hechadante neer jaasti waste aagtade. Neer jaasti waste aadre enagtade, the plant will not withstand that condition because the root is not able to absorb more water absorb madlikke adakke sadhyavagirudilla. Hagage en maadthade, leaf get modified into a needle like structure and it contains thick cuticle, and this needles or the leaf contain thick cuticle. Cuticle is nothing but the outer layer irutadalla, transparent layer, thick layer irutade, adanna cuticle anta heltare, okay. Thick cuticle and sunken stomata. Usually stomata is present like this. Idu leaf idu layer anta takondre epidermal layer, this is outer layer, okay. This is outer layer of the leaf, that is epidermis anta helteve, and on this you can see the thick deposition. Itara thick deposition, transparent deposition irtade, idanna cuticle anta heltare. This is nothing but the cuticle, and here normally hegirtade stomata, it is present embedded in the epidermal region. Epidermal region alli hegirtade normal plants alli, but in these plants, the plant which grow in extreme temperature condition, less water availability, again aagtade hegiddaga transpiration rate jaasti aagtade. Hagage en aagtade here, in this case the stomata will be just below the epidermis. ee epidermis athava outer layer irutadalla adra just below dalli develop aagtade. So the transpiration rate will be decreases. Rain aagtade transpiration decrease aagtade yavaga ee stomata region slightly below the epidermis. ee epidermal outer layer ginta swalpa kelagiddaga the transpiration rate will be decreased. That help to grow the plant, or that help the plant to grow in a extreme environmental condition. Hagage the extreme environmental condition alli grow aglikke help aagutade, okay. And next we'll move to the reproduction part, reproductory part of the gymnosperms. Okay, usually these gymnosperms, well, the sex organs or the specialized sex organ develop in same plant or in different plant. They may be develop in the same plant and different plant. Here they produce microspores. They produce microspores and megaspores. They produce larger spores called megaspores and smaller spores called as microspores. Usually microspores developed by the help present in the micro specialized leaf like structure, we'll call it as microsporophylls. Okay, specialized leaf like structurally in microspores develop after there, so that leaf we'll call it as microsporophyll. Usually this microsporophyll, this microsporophyll will develop in a central axis, the in central axis the leaf like structure itara somewhat this structure will be there. On this surface you can see the development of microsporangium. Microsporangium irthade specialized sac like structure, directly spores produce agudilla, ondu covered ಒಂದು ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಸ್ಯಾಕನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಪೊರಾಂಜಿಯಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆದರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಪರ್ಸ್, ಇವನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಟ್ಯಾಚಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ ಇದರೊಳಗಿದ್ರೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆದರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಬೇಗ ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗುವ ಮುಂಚೆ ಅದು ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಬೈ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ like structure, that we'll call it as microsporangium, and these leaf like structure will be arranged spirally arranged in a central axis. They may be spirally arranged in a central axis. ಈ central axis ಅಲ್ಲಿ spirally arrange ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, and form a cone like structure. This form a cone like structure called lax. This cone like structure we'll call it as lax or strobilus or cones. This cone like structure, the sporophylls which arranged spirally on the central axis and form a cone like structure, that we'll call it as lax, strobilus or cones. ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅನ್ನು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರೊಬೈಲಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕೋನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಕೋನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಪೋರೋಫಿಲ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೇರ್ಸ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಪೊರಾಂಜಿಯಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ cones contain microsporophyll along with the microsporangium, and inside the microsporangium there is a development of microspores. Okay, that microspores later give rise to a male gametophyte. So the male gamete producing cone is called as, the male gamete producing cone is called as microsporangiate or male cone or male strobilus. Male strobilus or microsporangiate or male cone, the microspore producing the cones are called as microsporangiate male cone or strobilus, male strobilus. Okay, usually it will give rise to, it contain microsporangium. Okay, inside this they contain a leaf like structure, itara leaf like structure develop aagtade, and inside that you can see the sac like structure. These are the sac like structures, and this, if you enlarge this sac like structure, you can see large number of the spores. You can see large number of spores. These spores are nothing but microspores. These spores are called as microspores. Here these microspores will develop into a male gametophyte. These microspore will give rise to, they divide and give rise to a male gametophyte. which is reduced structure. As compared to bryophytes and pteridophytes, we have studied a complete different, that is entirely independent male gametophytic structural, but prominent male gametophytic structure develop aagtide. But in case of this, in gymnosperms, the male male gametophyte is they are reduced, the structure is reduced, and only the male gametophytic structure confined to a few cells. Okay, they confined to only few cells. Only few cells of the microspores will develop into male gametophyte, and this male gametophyte is also called as pollen grain. This is a microspore will give rise to a male gametophyte. This is a reduced structure. This male gametophyte is a reduced structure, and they confine to only few cells. The development of male gametophyte, kelavondu cells alli matra develop aagtade. All the cells will not give rise to the male gametophyte. Only few cells will develop as a male gametophyte, and this male gametophyte is also called as pollen grains. Okay, enagtade ee microsporophyll alli en develop aagtade in female cone or strobilus alli, there contains a microsporophyll. Microsporophyll contain microsporangia. Inside that you can see the microspores. That microspores will give rise to the formation of pollen grains or male gametophyte. ಓಕೆ, ಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮಿಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಪೋಲನ್ ಗ್ರೇನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಈ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟೂಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಮೇಲ್, ಹೌ ದ ಪೋಲನ್ ಗ್ರೇನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಮೇಲ್ ಕೋನ್, ಹೇಗೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರೀಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಪರ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ದ ದೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್, ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಕೋಪಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ದೆ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫ್ರೀಲಿ ಫ್ಲೋ ಇನ್ air. Okay, they can carry from one place to another easily through winds or through air. This get easily transported. Okay, idanna easily transport madlikke help martade. Okay, next we'll move to the male gametophyte, that is male, how the female gametophyte, we studied the male gametophyte. Next we'll move to the female gametophyte, that is, okay, in female gametophytes they contain megasporophylls or megasporophylls ಅನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿರ್ತದೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ megasporophylls contains a specialized structure, we'll call it as megaspore, that give rise to the formation of ovules. Okay, that give rise to the formation of ovules. Okay, inside that ovule it contain a female gametophyte that we are going to study in a next class. Just remember these parts. Okay, these parts, how female gametophyte aagtade anta you just revise maadkoli, because this the definition given in textbook you can easily not understandable. Okay, so you have to understand the concept. Okay, thank you all my dear students.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.